Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to give a demo on microcontroller which is based on 80196KC. This is a single board microcontroller training kit based on 80196 microprocessor and which is very useful and widely used for training purpose for engineers to develop the hardwares and softwares for industrial process controls. Now we move on to explanation of some important features of this complete trainer board. Then I will explain you how to enter and assemble the cores in the complete trainer board using the 80196KC microprocessor, and then you will also execute programs and find out the results also. So this is the box of our trainer kit, 80196KC microcontroller trainer. And the order code of this trainer kit is 43216. This is also mentioned on the board, and this is the complete plastic casing design to prevent it from dust and other dirt equipments. After opening this case, you will find out the PCB and onboard IC components singly soldered on the complete PCB, so you can visualize all the components' important features on front panel also. The order code is 43216. You can use this order code to find and what you can learn from complete setup by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com. Now I will explain you all the main components of this system specification, in which the CPU is 8019KC, or you can use this 80196KB and 8051. All the CPUs can be compatible for this, and it is working at 12 MHz of speed. Then we have monitor EEPROM, 32 kilobytes of EEPROM loaded with powerful monitor program. Then we have RAM, 16K bytes of user RAM using 6264 expandable up to 64. You can expand the RAM up to 64 kilobytes also. Then we have battery, 3.6 volt nickel cadmium battery for user RAM. Then we have IO lines using 8255, 24 IO lines are presented on the terminals. Then we have keyboard, which is a 25 key hex keypad, consists of 8 keys for command and 16 keys for hexadecimal entry and 1 key for reset button. Then we have display of 8 digit 7 segment display, 4 digits for the address field and 4 digits for the data field. Then we have on-chip features, in which 8 buffer lines from the processor, 1 channel 10 bit analog to digital converter, 1 channel 1x3 PWM output, high speed IO HSIO port with 8 lines, 2 16 bit timer, 1 interrupt line. Then we can also interface the complete trainer board with serial interface using RS232 serial interface through RXTX line. Then we have all data, address and control signals in TTL compatible, available at 40 pin, 26 pin and FRC connector. The power supply, onboard power supplies are plus 5 volt 1 ampere and plus minus 12 volt at 250 milliampere. The operating temperature range is about 10 degrees to 50 degrees centigrade. You can use this in different features. So this is all about the features of this complete setup board. Now we will explain you the different commands of this key, how the command works and how we can enter the opcodes, and how we can perform different programs, sample programs using 80196KC microprocessor. Now after connecting the complete setup board with the 220 volt power supply source, the socket can be connected on the top right side of this, and there is a on off button also provided. So when you on the kit, you will find a display showing SCB196. So this is the symbol of 80196. Then the power LED is also on for transmission and receiver. This LEDs works for the transmitting and receiving. And now we explain the different keys commands, how the commands work and how we can enter the opcodes in this. So first we will start with this reset button. The reset button is required to reset the system. Then we have XMEM key, The XMEM key is to examine the memory and allows the users to examine any memory location. For this, if we press XMEM and then we can press any address, and again if we press XMEM, we can get the address at address 4000. We are getting the data value 00. You can XMEM and examine the memory at different location. If I again press this, I will reach to the incremental order to the next address. Now we will reach to 4001 at this location. Similar 00 is also the data. Similarly, you can examine different memories, and after you done your work, just press reset, you will return to the home screen. Then we have WMEM to modify the memory and allow users to modify any memory location. For this, if we press directly WMEM, it will show you error. And for modifying the memory or data at any memory location, first we press XMEM, go to any memory location like 400 where we have the enter the address display and address location, and press XMEM. Right now there is 00 showing in the data. If you want to enter the data, you can use the hexadecimal keys for providing the different codes. Let us say we are providing here ED for the data, but if I do not press the WMEM, the data will be not logged in at this location. If I press XMEM, press reset, and again we check the data at the location, here the data is still 00. For entering and loading the data at this location and modify the data at this location, we need to press the WMEM. So if I enter the data ED and then press WMEM, the data is stored at 4000 location. We can now check the data using XMEM key. The data is stored at this location. Then we have use key. The use key contains multifunctionality like single instruction, downloading, etc. Then we have move key. The move key is to block move of memory of some other area. Then we have previous key. Previous is used as an intermediate terminator in case of examine memory, and it displays the PC contents of the data field to the address display in the address location as well. So in this, we can use this previous key for checking the previous address of the XMEM key. So if we press XMEM and check the location of memory, here it is 00. If I enter value E9 and press WMEM, then we enter value 45, press WMEM. In some memories location, if we want to check the previous location of this memory, we can press the previous. We reach to the decremental order for previous location like this. And previous key is also used for displaying the PC contents of the data field to address display in the address location. Then we have MON key, MON, monitor key, or MON key we can say. Terminator is used to terminate any command. If we are working on any command, like I have pressed the execute XMEM command, if we press MON command, this will terminate the command and we can reset and change the command as well. If I enter WMEM like this, and if I press WMEM and press MON key, the command is terminated. Now we can again execute the other command. Then we have execute key. The execute key is used to executing the program in full clock speed. Then we have F key. The F key is used to block top and block end key. It will enter the complete block description from address 400, and to enter the address of last location 40FF, then we can use this F key for different values. Then we have 0 to F. The 16 different hexadecimal keys for entering the hexadecimal value in the hexadecimal coding. And in the user manual, the hardware description, complete detail about the hardware and different devices which are used with this complete setup box, serial interfacing are also given in the user manual. You can read out all the commands, keyboard commands and different values for the detailed description, detail execution and detail study of the complete trainer board. You can also communicate this trainer board with the serial commands. The serial command and using procedure are also given in this user manual. You can follow this procedure and then you can get the programming, downloading, uploading and communicating with the PC using RS232 cable. So now we are moving to some sample programs for seeing the working of 80196KC microcontroller. For this, there is program 3. This program is for displaying the goodbye on the 7 segment display. So we have to enter the program from the starting address 4000 and complete opcodes by per address increment is had to be entered, and then we will execute the program and see what we can get in the result output. So we'll enter the program using starting address 400. I will show you first example completely entering in the kit, then we will execute some more programs. Now for entering the program, we will start entering the program at first we press reset. Now we'll press XMEM and go to the desired starting address location at where we have to enter the program. So we have reached the address location 400. If I press XMEM, there is some value. We have to change this value using this hex keys. So we'll enter the value B1 as described in the user manual. Then we press WMEM to load the value. So we'll press WMEM. Now we'll reach the next address, which is 4001. At here we have to enter the middle value, which is 06. So we'll enter 06 at here. Again we press WMEM, then we press EF, press WMEM, then we press B1, WMEM, 19, next EE, next B1, next 19, next ED, next. In any of the location, if you lost the location and your program is at some other location, if you want to check your entries properly, just press previous button and match the following entries from starting address. So we reached address 4001 and then you can press the XMEM for incrementing and checking the memory. So at 400 we have entered B1, which is right. At 4001 we have entered 06, it is also correct. Then EF, it is also correct. B1 correct. 19 we have to enter here. So we have lost the value at location 4004, so we have to correct this here. We have to again change the value 19 and press WMEM. At next location we have to enter EE. Then at next location we have to enter B1. Then we have to enter 19, it is correct right now, and again we'll press WMEM or XMEM to enter the value. Then at 4008 we are getting ED, which is correct. Now we go to the next value, which is B1. Then we have to enter 0D, EC, B1 again, at D we have to enter 14, then EB, then B1, 0B, EA, B1, Here we have got some other value. Starting fields are not displaying, so we can press reset over here and again check the values from XMEM. All the values should be proper. So we have entered till 4010. At 40F we have entered B1. Now at 4010 we have to enter 0B. Press WM, EA, B1, 13, E9, B1, 0E, E8, EF, 95. E1, E7, E2 and FF. So our all values has been now entered. Now we will execute the program. Also, you can first verify your all entries and you can also execute the program directly. But if the program does not execute properly, then again check all the entries of opcodes. If you find errors, there should be errors if you are not getting the execute program answer. So now we are going to execute the program. For executing the program, just press monitor key, then press starting address of your program and then press execute. As we press execute, you can see there is displayed goodbye in the 7 segment 8 digit display. So that's how we execute, enter all the opcodes and then we execute the program and execution result is over on the screen right now. Similarly, we can enter all different programs. I will show you one or more examples so you can easily get to know how to do executing and how to do programming on this trainer board. Now in next example, we will enter a program for moving display. In this program, 8, the digit 8 will be rotated from right to left in the 7 segment display. So we'll enter the program completely from starting address 400 to 4037's last ending address and then we execute the program. So for saving the time in the video, I am directly executing and entering the program from starting address 400 and after complete execution, I will show you executing the program directly. Now, so I have entered the complete program from the starting address 400 to the last digit of 4037 series. Now we will execute the program. For executing the program, you can directly enter the address and press execute. Now as I press execute, you can see the digit 8 is rotating from right to left on the 7 segment 8 digit display. So that's how we execute program for this feature as well. Now we will execute program for some higher advanced feature in which we will generate some waveforms for this. So we will do the PWM generation program from this 80196 KC trainer. The program and opcodes are given in the program number 4, program for PWM output. We need to adjust some points in which we will see the pulse width output on the pin number 30 and at connector CN1. So CN1 is here. At this connector, we will be seeing the output of the pin number 30 and we can also modulate by changing duty cycle, also can be changed by changing the register content at location 4004. So we'll do this program. For this, just press reset and again start entering the program for starting address 4000. Here we will enter B1 0116 B1 80 1C B0 1C C देन 17, 28, 02, 27, F9, B1, 19, 1E, E0, 1E, FD, F0. Now we will verify our program with the executing code given in the user manual. For this, just press XMEM, and now we will press WMEM, sorry, XMEM again, and here we will verify the all opcodes. So at this location, B1 should be entered, so B1 is correct. Then 0116, B1 80, 1C, B0, 1C, 17, 28, 02, 27, F9, B1, 19, 1E, E0, 1E, FD, F0. So our program has been now verified also. Now we'll execute the program. For this, we have to do some setup connection over here. We need to connect any connector to check out at pin number 30, and also we will check out the waveforms. For this, we required a CRO or DSO for checking the PWM output. So I will arrange the setup. So here I have set up the CRO or DSO for observing the PWM waveforms. Right now you can see our program is not executing, so we will first check at pin number 30 whether there is output given or not using the CRO. I have used this budget strip so that I can easily connect only ground pin. Make sure there is a ground and positive pin near about both, so that you do not short both the pins, otherwise your program will be disappear from the memory. So carefully connect ground pin on the ground one, and here at the 5 pins above there is the 30th number pin on the connector CN1. So if I am connecting the probe on this, there is no output. Now if I execute the program inside the PCB or inside the 80196 controller, for executing we will enter 4000 and press execute. Here we can say there are PWM pulse which are generated at the connector CN1. It can be required to use at any of the process controlling and any of the different values. Now if we want to change the duty cycle and width of this, we have to change the value of address 4004. For this we will press reset. As I press reset, the waveform disappears. Now we will follow the user manual in which we have to change the value at 4004. So we'll go to value 4004 XMEM. This is the pulse width already given in data form. So if I change this to 40, there might be the half of the pulse or it might be the double. It depends on the hex code codings. Press WMEM, press reset. Now we'll again execute the program. Carefully connecting the ground pin and 40th pin, sorry, 30th pin, and execute the program. Here you can see now pulse width is now narrower, about the half. So we can again change the pulse width to any other value. This time we will attain some higher value. So we'll change this to 90 and again execute the program. Here again we have got the higher pulse width than the earlier. So that's how we can execute the pulses over here. You can do all the different practicals given in the user manual for practicing purpose. There are a lot of practical and memories and lot of scope to learning about development of different type of process control, programming, software development. So this is a basic kit. I have explained you the basic of this. You can do go on with the practicing with your own for entering the different codes, so that you can easily get up and learn about the 80196 KC controller. So that was the complete demonstration of 80196 KC microcontroller trainer. You can do all the experiments, all the sample program given in the user manual. Also study about the hardware, softwares, how you can do coding and development through this trainer board. Also, if you find difficulties while executing and performing the programs, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all types of supports. If you like the video, if you get the knowledge about this type of programming controlling, you can press the like button, and also you can share this video to your friends, classmates and colleagues to get the knowledge about these types of development board. You can also subscribe our channel. There are a lot of video uploaded about different practical information with the different educational trainer boards. Also, don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video, you will get to notified that about also. Till then, thank you for watching this video, and we will meet in the next video very soon.